Okay, now that I have a decent camera, I was thinking maybe I should do some of my older videos or gun reviews, sort of redo them, and I can give a little better, like, up close views, the different markings, this kind of stuff. But I figured I'd start one of my more favorite 22s. Most people know I like really like 22 single shots. I think some people kind of outgrow them, or they think they do. But I find for a nice laid-back shooting session at the range or something, there's nothing more fun than like a single shot 22. Like semi-autos and repeaters are fun, but I don't know. You kind of like with semi-autos, it seems like you're always loading magazines and stuff. That kind of annoys me after a while, but. With this one, you load the gun, it's loaded, and when you shoot it, then you just reload it again. Like, it's not a big, you don't have to worry about loading magazines with a single shot. But this is my GECO model 1925. I'll try to get the markings here, get them up close for you. Zoom in on it there. Original GECO carabiner model 1925. Let's get a fixed back sight. Just a front kind of inverted V front sight. It appears to be sort of a fixed 20 meters or so, which is, for hunting ranges, that's almost perfect. And it's pretty hard for it to get out of alignment. And nice little wooden stock on it. It's not, retardedly thin, but it's not big and chunky. It's got a little pistol grip on there, so it's pretty nice. And we got caliber spelled with a K, 22 long rifle. That's 5.4. Whoop, easy now. 5.4 millimeter. So I guess that would be the bore diameter. And then their crest is on there. GECO. Or GECO. So maybe these guys sell insurance? I don't know. But anyway. And you get on the side here what GECO stands for. Gustav Jinzhou. You guys can read it before I butcher the shit out of it. And company. Let's see here. Waffenfabriks, Berlin, and then there's, what's this place here? Oh. Anyway, you get the gist of it. Anyway, but it's a very simple, it's a little single shot, bolt action. There's no real safety or anything. The bolt handle locks in there. It's got the European style extractor, which is the bottom of the. Let's see here. Try to get a view of that for you. It's the bottom part of the chamber there. The bolt pulls it back and forth. It goes forward with the bolt like that. You can see it's down in there now. You can see it takes like half of the chamber, so it gets a pretty good purchase on the shell. The only thing really wrong with it is you can shoot the gun without it, and if you do, then the shell will kind of will fail. But so you can see there, as you pull the bolt back, it pulls it, and then when he gets to the last of it, see, it gives it a little nudge up, and you give it a yank, and it'll kind of throw the shell out. So it's really positive. The shell's pretty much going to come out of there. But it's a really nice little gun. I guess these are fairly common in the States. They're really inexpensive. Think a lot of them were built, I don't know if they were like in the 1950s or between the war or something like that. But it's got a little steel butt plate on it. Everything's, wood and steel. They're really simple, and they hold up really well. I've really been happy with it. It's It's quite accurate for the, you know, for the style of sights that it has. There's no real safety, but I think I mentioned that in my old video. Some guy left a comment recently that you just put the shell in, pull the trigger, and close the bolt, like, behind it kind of deal. But then you got your cocking piece sitting on the firing pin, which is sitting on the rim of the shell, which is probably not the best idea, but kind of run into the same kind of thing people are talking with the Mosin and this stuff. But little stamp trigger guard there, everything, and it's got the German proof marks on it, B and U. Usually there's a one with a G or something. They call it like the bug proof marks or something they call it. This one's only got B and U for some reason. Maybe it wasn't fully proofed, I don't know. It's a great little gun. It's right up there. I take this to the range quite a lot, or go rabbit hunting, take it and stuff. But so anyway, hope that's a little better video. Very nice little gun, actually. Anyway, talk to you guys later.